We're over at ISE 2017 with the Senior Education team, and we're joined by Alex from Josh AI to talk about voice control in home automation. Now, you guys are the real experts in making sure that we don't need to touch a button anymore. Everything activated by the voice. So let's start off, what is this technology and what's available in the market?
Sure, so voice control is a very hot topic right now, but it's also very new. There are essentially three players at the voice side. We've got Amazon with the Alexa, Google Home with a much newer product but a really good microphone, and then my company, Josh AI. Now, in some cases, we all work together. In other cases, we compete.
And how do these systems differ? Are they hardware? Are they software? Are they integrated with other products?
So both Amazon and Google Home are essentially smart microphones. And so it's a hardware platform that then is able to do language processing. So there's a software layer as well. On the Josh side, we're actually a full control system, and so we have essentially a black box that's in the closet, but we do all the language processing as well. So that's why we might work with Amazon using their microphones and our control system.
And what are the capabilities of voice control? How much of our home automation system can we actually control, and to what level?
My place, for example, I can open my garage doors, control lights by floor or room, play music, but by music I can issue specific artists, play the Beatles, I can say play a song, play an album, play a genre, and that's often through Sonos or different integrations. I've got a fountain set up, I've got various cameras that depending on the screen I can voice command and say, show me the camera in the kitchen. So pretty much everything that can be integrated with a control system can be integrated with voice as well.
And with regards to the voice, I know that there are dialects out there, of course. Is it going to understand everybody's voice? I know it's English language, most of it at the moment, but does it need to learn our voice?
It does not need to learn. The way the technology works today is really interesting, but basically the first thing you need to do is convert the spoken word to written text, because all the processing takes place around the written text. Converting the spoken word to the written text is done through a technology called ASR. It's automatic speech recognition. And that technology is coming out of companies like Google, Microsoft, Amazon, Apple, and it's basically being open source so most people can use it because they're training on millions of people's phone data from Android phones and iPhones. It's getting really good without needing to be trained on the individual user today.
Now, it's a great technology and it's so easy to use, but Do we need to secure this? Is there any way that somebody can walk past your house, for instance, Alex, and say, open the garage?
So some of these precautions are already there. So if you have a hands-free microphone like the Amazon Echo, they actually won't allow you to voice command alarm systems, garage doors, and locks without a voice PIN code. That being said, a lot of our customers like using their phone as the interface because then it's really secure and locked down.
So, as an integrator, if you're going to design this into a system, what are the main things that we need to think about with regards to connectivity, Wi-Fi, bandwidth, and everything else?
So, the first thing is you need to make sure you have a good network. Unfortunately, right now, all the voice processing is in the cloud, at least the speech-to-text portion of it. And so, if you're trying to build voice control on a yacht with uncertain, you know, networking capabilities, it's just not going to work that well today. So, first thing is audit the network. Make sure the network's great. The next thing is audit the devices, because if you can't control the devices with a button, it's not going to work with voice. The next piece is when you're setting up the voice control, you want to make sure that you give rooms, devices, and scenes really good natural names and aliases. That way, turn on the kitchen and turn on the food room will both activate the lights in that same room. And so that's a more manual process, but that's part of the whole system.
So I've seen a big marketing campaign from Amazon with the Echo of recent, just before Christmas and into the new year, as really the ability to control the whole home and every device within it. Is this realistic right now? Are there limitations right now? And what's going to happen in the future?
So it's realistic that if you have a control system controlling devices, you can voice control those systems. That being said, the more esoteric the command and the device type, the more hard-coded the voice command is going to be. And so when you see a lot of these commercials, customers get it in their minds that this is Jarvis from Iron Man. They can do anything. The reality is the voice commands are still a lot more simplistic than how we would talk to one another. And so as we start integrating these systems, we just need to remind customers that their expectations need to be realistic.
And is this exactly the same technology as with our Siri? And can we use Siri to integrate into the home automation?
So Apple has a software product called HomeKit, mm-hmm. and that's how Siri would do it. The reality is HomeKit doesn't work with many devices. And so Siri is not currently an option if you have a real control system like Control 4, Crestron, or even Josh. That being said, I would argue Siri is not what you think of when you're going in and wanting to control your home. It's what you think of when you're wanting to send a text message or dictate into your phone. And so I think people parse out Siri to be sort of when I'm doing stuff with my phone versus interacting with the world around me.
So you guys do this professionally, of course. There are so many opportunities out there for people to go and just buy it off the shelf. Is that realistic, or is this something that the integrator should be doing with the home?
So what we find is there are three different distinct levels of voice control in the home. The basic level is essentially that. You buy an Amazon Echo, maybe some Philips Hue light bulbs, and the homeowner by themselves can set that up and do it. Now that's sort of the basic level. The more advanced level is you want to be able to say good morning and have your shades open, your lights go on, maybe the TV switch on to CNN. And so to set up a scene, that needs a control system, and that's not something they're going to do on their own. The more advanced level, though, sort of level three for us, is what we call deep linking, which is I want to play a specific artist in a specific room, or I want to say, show me a recent movie with Pierce Brosnan, for example. And the system's smart enough to figure out what that is, boots up the TV, switches to the right source, and launches right into it. That's possible today, but not with the off-the-shelf tools. That needs to be integrated.
So your level three is as good as it gets, Alex. Tell us about your favorite system and what that's capable of.
That's a good question. My favorite system is really hard to analyze only because I use a whole lot of stuff. You know, in my home, just the ability to wake up and naturally speak a variety of commands. But the specific feature that I would say was really interesting was I'm based in Los Angeles, and we have a few celebrity clients, one of which was really excited about being able to voice control his steam shower. He said it takes about 10 minutes for the steam shower to set up when he has to press the button, and he often wants to do it when he's driving home, not even there. And so now being able to say, you know, turn on the steam shower 10 minutes beforehand for him was a big wow factor. And for us, that was cool because it was actually easy to integrate and delighted him.
So if we can just look a little further ahead, let's say 3 to 5 years, what's going to be the next steps in the technology, do you think?
There are a few things that we're excited about. The first one is multilingual. Right now, most of this technology is in English, but it's not going to be that way forever. The next is introducing more artificial intelligence. Right now, voice commands work for pre-programmed rooms and scenes, but the system should be able to create ad hoc scenes based on knowing your habits versus my habits and how I'd want to be able to issue those. So for example, I should be able to say on my phone when I'm driving, Josh, I'm on my way home. And Josh knows based on the time of day, what day of the week it is, and what my preferences are, what to do. And that I think we're going to see in the next couple years. Otherwise, gesture control is really interesting. With voice, I sometimes want to say, turn that off or turn that on. Mm-hmm. And maybe I'm pointing to a TV or a light or speakers. And if you can do gesture control plus voice control, that makes it even more magical.
There's going to be some really exciting developments in gesture control, in voice control coming up. Thanks, Alex. How can we find out more about Josh.ai?
Our website is Josh.ai, and we're Josh.ai on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram.
We've got plenty more information on home automation on the HowToAV.tv channel. Loads more coming from ISE 2017. Don't forget to subscribe. Keep viewing. Alex, thank you for your time.
Thank you.